losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. But baby, I've been praying hard. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll be counting stars.
Speaker who's going to give us a masterclass in HTA, that's Stefan Holmstrom, who's director of HEOR in Astellas. And also we're going to talk about coming together, the HTAs and the regulators, for good advice and quick patient access of vital medicines, a myth or reality. And Mira Pavlovic is going to, who is deputy director of HAS in France, the HTA body, is going to give us an overview of that.
Before we start, I just thought, because I'm so used to these abbreviations, I'm probably going to throw in words like HTA, market access, HEOR, payers, and ICERs. So for those of you who are not familiar with those, I thought it's probably good to actually start with just defining a little bit on these words. So HTA, and Mira is going to talk much more about HTA in general, health technology assessment. So this is obviously a body in evaluating your drug from a health technology point of view. Market access is a very broad broad definition of what we actually do. Market access can actually include everything that we do in one sense, because it's all about how we actually get the product out to the markets. How do we actually get the product to the patient? But market access tends to be also, once you have the product approved, and life cycle management, market access, which includes also the regional aspects of that. Health economics outcome research, I'm sure most of you are familiar, which is basically putting it together from a health economics point of view. Payers, I'm using rather broadly sometimes, which really includes HTAs, regional, national payers as well. So if I say payer, that's probably what I'm thinking about. ICER is the incremental cost effectiveness ratio, which is something that health economics is using in terms of trying to understand the benefit and the cost in one go. So that, for instance, for the UK, we have a threshold of an ICER, which is somewhere in the range of £20,000 to £30,000 per quality gain. And therefore, we have very strict guidance on what is required. So changing environment, we all know that we are today in a very strict environment. We have aging population at the same time as we have very, very strict cost containment measures in all of the countries that we live in. I'm pretty sure all of you are today much more cost conscious than you were maybe even 2 or 3 years ago about how you're actually spending your own money. And this is the same for countries as well.
Thank you very much. So I don't know if it was you, Craig, who gave me this topic and this very challenging title, but I'll try to cover it. Because when I read it now, I'm not sure that I can cover everything. So HTAs and regulators together for good scientific advice. Let's see. For quick patient access. And of vital new medicines. Is it a myth or reality? So let's begin. We'll see how far we get with all this. So together, I will tell you recent news and about the initiative of multi-HTA early dialogues. So for those who are not familiar with HTA, I think that Stefan has set the scene perfectly well, explaining what HTA is and what we are to do together. So this is just to tell you that there is a mandate for European collaboration in HTA, and there is Article 15 of the Directive on the Application of Patients' Rights in Cross-Border Healthcare, asking HTA bodies to support cooperation in exchange of scientific information among member states within a voluntary network connecting HTA bodies. Voluntary network is here in bold letters because I think that the half of you will imagine that we shall have a kind of HTA agency, official one, tomorrow morning or the day after. And for the moment, what we are trying to do is to have an efficient and voluntary network of HTA bodies to exchange scientific information. So, relative effectiveness assessment, as Stefan explained, is and will be done at national level, but European cooperation will bring added value for developing data for relative effectiveness and methodological challenges.